it's different. It's not a 9-to-5 job. You don't sit there and do the same thing every day. And the music, that's the type of music I like. I like rock.
You've seen them in videos by Motley Crue, Rod Stewart, Eddie Money, Giorgio, Gerardo, Bon Jovi, and more. They're the fantasy women who climb the charts with the stars, the rock video girls. Now, exclusive interviews with the starlets who help make the stars' videos soar. Plus, exciting, never-before-seen original rock video footage.
The videos I've done, I kind of can be myself and just do whatever I want to. I mean, there's always direction, but you can pretty much have a feel for, you know, what you want to do and how you want to make that part happen.
It's more of like you're in a sensual dream. Videos are very sexy, and a lot of times they're very dark, and it's very mysterious. And I think that we all get to play out our fantasies when we're in videos.
I love rock and roll. It's the guys, sure, it's working with the artists. Most of all, it's just great to see myself on TV.
And the best part is acting, because you can give a lot of yourself and play different people that you're not, right? And that's very important.
It's fun. I can't describe it. It's like people always say, well, don't you ever get sick of doing that? No, because they're so interesting. You meet so many artistic people and you get so much different input from people. It's really fabulous to work on them. Hard work, but good.
I think I enjoy torturing people the most. You can kind of walk the shoes by them and go, you're going to be in these for 6 hours, and the look of terror on their face is great.
Well, I'm from Canada, and before I came here, I was in university, where I graduated with a bachelor's degree in psychology and phys ed. And I was also a nationally ranked athlete in track and field. I've set a lot of records, and apparently some of them are still standing. Well, when I moved here 5 years ago, I used to work with Arsenio and Eddie Murphy for like almost 3 years. In fact, I was Eddie's executive assistant at Paramount. And I watched a lot, kind of like what everybody's doing here. I watched a lot, and I learned a lot, and it looked a lot of fun to try to do it the other way, which is like being in front of the camera. And they kind of said, hey, why don't you try it? And I'm here, trying it. So now I get to do videos and other things. One video I did, we were in a graveyard, and they wrapped this big, huge snake around me. And they didn't really know a lot about the snake, and it started to choke me. I don't know if it was funny, but they thought it was funny. And they had to have the whole crew come up and yank this big snake off. But it was interesting. I kind of like left my body, one of those out-of-body experiences. You float away.
And now I know my place. In this life I arrive. And I know the things I feel. Are burning deep inside. So if you want a medieval, I'm the one, I'm the one. I'm the one, I'm the one.
One of the latest videos I did was doing like a love scene on like on camera, but it was really interesting doing it in front of like 30 people. And they said, we'll clear the set. Now I saw people like hanging from the rafters, people like picking in the windows. And so it wasn't really all that closed of a set. I figured like to get to know them a little bit prior to having to do this. I didn't expect like 7:30 in the morning we'd be like rolling around. And not knowing him was a little bit uncomfortable, and his manager kept going, "Remember, you're like two wild animals." And he'd come up, he goes, "Just remember that." He says, "So be everything that you can be today. This is your man." And I'm like, 7:30 in the morning. And he would like, he was like, kind of like another director in the room. "Yes, yes, come on, do it." And I'm like, but that video was really, really pretty. Even though it's sensual, there's a lot of niceness showing that it's just not sex, 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 you know. And I think that it will be a nice message to, like, people, hopefully in a real spiritual, wonderful, positive way of love and it all being there. So it's one of my favorite.
I'm going down.
Of the videos, it's interesting, you know. It's not, I hate everyday thing, I hate a routine thing, and that's just the reason why I do the videos. It has, you know, it's nothing to do that I'm playing another part or I'm not playing myself, because to a point you are always playing yourself, no matter if it's you're playing a hooker or if you're playing a princess. It doesn't matter, there's always a little bit of yourself that comes out, and no matter what you do, people do recognize me outside of the video land. The younger they are, the more, you know, it's weird for me, because I'm like, oh, I didn't really do anything. They're almost starstruck, and to me that's unusual, you know. And mostly little kids, they come up and they're just in just a gaze, you know, looking at you. Or they're real jealous too, because a lot of fans, when you're in the video with the rock person that they are head over heels in love with, and you are the girl that they are singing to, there's a lot of jealousy there. And there's a lot of, you know, they really either, they want to come and talk to you because you know this person, or they just hate you. Several funny, crazy things happen to me on videos. I'm a complete spaz. I always do something that shocks everybody. And when I auditioned for the Great White video, they asked me if I could ride a Harley.
Now, still to this day, they don't believe me, but I can. But I drove Sportsters before, which to me is a 500-pound bike. When we got there, I must have weighed about 1,500 pounds, I would say. And I'm like, I weigh 110 pounds. There's no way. I mean, I was fine until I'd stop, and then I'd just fall over. It was too heavy. And I still get it from that. Never fails, but no, yes. I can drive a Harley, is what I'm trying to say, and it was way too heavy. I dropped it several times. Into lampposts, onto stage, into the camera. I made a complete ass out of myself, but it was fun. And people still to this day see me on the street and say, you're the girl that crashed the Harley. Yes, that's me. That's how I refer to myself now.
Wild thing, I think you move me. But I wanna know for sure.
The experience that I had working on the rock videos, it was not what I expected. It was a lot more fun. The way the rock stars are in the video, the way they are to work with us, they seem kind of shy sometimes because they think, you know, just because we're a pretty girl that they're afraid to come up and talk to us. And sometimes they're kind of nervous about, you know, talking to us.
Do you feel women are exploited in rock videos?
The way I feel about the rock videos, and I know, in a lot of these rock videos that we are male fantasies, but hey, I mean, that's what it's about, right? It's rock videos. I'm not uptight about the whole thing. I mean, I'm proud of my body. I feel good about it. What the heck? Go for it, you know? That's what this is all about.
Got shot.
What makes a guy sexy? Gosh, this is gonna go on forever.
A man that's real positive about himself. A man that's not afraid to approach me or talk to me.
He has to have a really cute voice. I love a cute voice.
Someone that knows what they want, is not afraid to go after it.
I have to have fun with him. And I have to be able to be myself around him and be kind of weird, because I'm, for the more part, I am pretty weird. kind of crazy, wild and crazy?
Oh, that's a good question. Well, I couldn't talk physically because a man, you know, physically, obviously, you know, if he's good built, he's sexy automatically.
Looks don't hurt, but pretty much it's really what's inside them that I think is really sexy.
If he dresses well, if he's well-spoken, and if he treats a woman correctly, that's about it.
Someone whose sexuality comes from within, not someone who's too worried about what they look like or what they're wearing.
It has nothing to do with the music they sing. That, to me, I don't find that sexy. I don't find how much makeup they have on sexy or anything like that. It's just the person.
I love the guys in rock and roll. There's a certain sex appeal to them that a lot of people don't see unless you're into rock and roll.
What makes a man sexy is when he's signed power of attorney over to you. Very sexy.
A sexy man, I would say, would be unconscious or dead and have a lot of money.
Before I got into modeling, I was an assistant buyer for a sporting goods company. I would try on the swimwear when the sellers would come in with their merchandise. And one day, one of the guys asked if I wanted to do a show, and the show was only 3 days, and I made more money in the 3 days that I did in a whole week in retail, because retail really doesn't pay unless it's your own company. And I hate the beach and mountains too. The Dwight Yoakam one was a really kind of scary one, but it was cool. Lucasfilms did it, and they kind of had a bar scene, and it was like the Star Wars bar scene when everyone, all those funky characters and the masks and everything was going on. I was strung from the ceiling with ropes on an old, like, old antique kind of saddle, and it was, like, barely hanging on there, and they, like, got me up into it every day with a ladder, because we did it for, like, 2 days, because it just took forever. And I was dressed in like this little black net thing and hip high boots and some black vinyl cones was like the chest wear. And I was kind of swinging back and forth on top of Dwight while he was doing his little bit. And I hate the countryside too. And I hate everything about you. Did I ever meet a nice guy in any of the rock videos? Yeah, I did. I met a really nice guy, and we were together for about a year and a half. I tended to stay away from doing rock videos for a while because I heard so many horror stories about the guys, and when I did this one, I ran into a guy, and he was just a sweetheart, an absolute sweetheart, and changed my whole view of rockers. Some say I got a bad attitude, but that don't change the way I feel about you. And if you think this might be bringing me down, look again, cause I ain't wearing no frown. Fun things in videos. One thing that I really liked in the Slaughter video, the Up All Night video, I had these two big dogs, and I'm like walking down a dark alley, and it was so cold. It was like
December when we were shooting, and it had been raining, and then of course they had to wet the whole ground down, and we had a big fire in a can next to me and some vagrants type people hanging out, and I'm walking these two huge dogs. One of them was twice as strong as I was, and I had on really high spike heels, like 6 inches, and they had their trainers like standing right on the other side of the camera calling them so they'd walk faster, and I'm like holding on to these dogs, and I almost fell. I don't know how many times I almost fell, but it was really kind of scary, but it was fun too, because then at the end I would stand up and the dog, this one big male dog, would come and like sit on my feet and keep me warm.
Originally from Russia, and I've been in the United States for 11 years, and half of that in New York and the other half here. Something that I remember is a recent video called, it was a video by Robbie Robertson called What About Now, and in it I had a love scene, and I came in at 8 o'clock in the morning, said hello to the guy who was playing my boyfriend, and basically 15 minutes later, you know, we were there in this bedroom that the bed was made of cardboard. It was a make-believe bed, and it was really small. We both had to fit on it. And, you know, we'd start doing this romantic love scene, and I'm thinking about how do my legs look, the angle of my face. And just when we'd get, like, right to the moment, we'd both fall off the bed because it was a cardboard, and it would just tip over. And I don't know how many times we must have done that, but I guess that was, also we shot in New Orleans, and one of the scenes that we had to do was in a cemetery, and that was pretty spooky, I guess. I love cemeteries, but most people thought it was kind of weird. It was beautiful, and the mood was perfect for it, and it was just raining a little bit, and just felt like I was in a movie.
I'm half Yugoslavian, I'm from Yugoslavia, and half Sicilian, okay? But I moved in Paris when I was 12 years old, so I did most of my education in Paris. And how did I get into modeling? I was just walking in the street, you know, after, you know, school, and that person came up to me and goes, "Who are you with?" And I'm like, "Who am I with? I'm with nobody." I'm like, "What do you want?" And she said, "You should be a model, you should be a model." I go, "Okay, whatever." And I just followed her, you know? She was not a pervert or anything, so it was fine. Well, let me tell you something. First of all, when I see the girls on MTV, I said to myself, "No way, they're so beautiful. There's no way I can get into that business." I said, "Look at those beautiful girls." So just to tell you that I maybe look pretty today, but it's all light and makeup, you know? Usually I do work with the people in the band. I mean, It's always always a little story, you know. I'm always playing the love partner or, you know, the interest. So obviously I am working with them and it's fun.
So Blueberry, what else? Any other funny things happen to you making rock videos?
What else happened? I have a good one. I was shooting that video, you know, I had a lot of acting, you know. I was supposed to get really mad and I was on the loft, you know. And it was so many things. He said, you can throw anything you want, and the loft is huge. I mean, it's like really far. They were shooting from very far up, right? So here I am getting mad, break the light, everything, grab a big heavy shoe, like, you know, like those army shoes, like those guys wear, and I throw it so hard, so far, hit the director in the head. I mean, what do you say? And the guy goes, keep going, keep going. I'm like, what do you mean keep going? He's almost passed out on the floor, and I keep talking and like getting mad. I mean, and everybody looked at me and I go, okay, next take, I promise I won't throw the shoe. But I didn't know it was going to go so far. So here I am, I hit a director. Oh well. Sometimes when you mess up, you know, on the take, for example, I was on that Dweezil Zappa video, and it was really simple. I just had to walk to that door, kick the door with my legs, and take off that sticky coat, you know, it was made out of plastic. And I was sweating, so you imagine to take off the coat, like being really sexy, you know, take off your coat. But no, it stick up to me, and so I was like shaking and shaking that coat, never get off. And they kept it on the video, so it was pretty fun. Yeah, something like that. Well, when they recognized me, it's really funny actually, because I was doing a big fashion show and with big models, you know, and those kids, I mean, all those young kids, like 15, 16, came after the show and go, excuse me. I said, that can't be enough for me. And they go, excuse me, are you Blueberry, the girl from Eddie Money and Richard Marx? Oh, that's so great. Can I have your autograph? I go, okay, you know, but I was like really surprised that just by video that people are very attracted by, you know, music videos and the girl works with the bands because you're the goddess for them. It's, yeah, quite nice.
And we're dancing to the beat of the drum, baby. Dancing in the morning sun, baby. Like the moon whipping up on me, pretending everything's all right. You hold me like I would run away, baby. I can't give you a promise I'd stay, baby.
Modeling, I was back in Seattle, Washington. I just came from high school. After I graduated, I came out here with really no goal. I just came out here to do whatever I wanted, some excitement in my life. And I found it. I was submitted through my agency for this video, and the casting director didn't pick me through my picture. So I just figured I didn't get cast for the video, and I was in Ralph's grocery store. And the guys from Danger Danger saw me, my girlfriend and I actually, and asked us if we wanted to do the video. So I thought it was just a scam because I didn't recognize him at first. Then I, you know, I was looking at him like, oh yeah, you guys are the guys from Danger, Danger. And so he asked us to do the video and set us up with the call time and all that stuff. Ended up, I did the video and I met the casting director on there and she saw, you look familiar, you know. She's like, oh yeah, I saw your picture, but I didn't pick you. How come you're on this set, you know? I go, oh, well, the guys picked me. So that's how I got casted for the Danger, Danger video. It was kind of funny. We had a little, like, bedroom scene where he was watching football, and I was, like, trying to get his attention. Then I get the whipped cream out, and I'm, like, spraying it all over him. And then we start kissing, and, you know, it was just kind of like a Sunday afternoon type of thing. Kind of like the perfect little, you know, episode. The Gerardo video was the best. It was so much fun filming because I was nude through the whole thing. And so I had to, like, I was comfortable with him because I had dated him before. He said this in the making of, too, so I feel like I can say it. Anyways, I was nude through the whole thing, and he had to, like, wear his little brief underwear, you know, to make it look like he was nude, but he wouldn't get nude. Anyways, it was just fun because the whole time, every time we'd do a take, we'd say, no, you know how usually you want to get it done, but this time we were like, no, we'll do another take, you know, so we kept on doing more and more. Just turned out to be a lot of fun because it was so their kissing scenes and stuff. So it was better than the usual, just plain old video. We were kind of into it. In the Motley Crue video, we did a lot of dancing and, you know, real seductive type of dancing and things like that. So it was mostly me, whatever I wanted, however I wanted to do it. And Phil, that was how it was done. Promise me, I had a lot more fun in the Motley Crue video than, you know, a couple other videos I did because they were more into it and they, it's kind of like a party. I haven't had one group that I've worked with so far that hasn't treated me perfect, just like a queen. I mean, I've been treated very good through every video I've worked with, you know, and especially Motley Crue. I mean, Gerardo, he treated me good and we knew each other, so I expected to be treated good, you know. But Motley Crue, they were the best team I've ever worked with. They were so nice. Treated us really, really good. Most of them love what they're doing. And that makes me more positive and makes me work harder. A lot of the guys, they are really energetic. I noticed in the rock videos also, for the more part, they're real energetic. They love what they're doing. And they're in there to have fun. It's not just like a job to them. And it makes the girls have a lot more fun in their videos also.
Conversation. Don't wanna talk about. baby, do you good on the trunk and on the hood. Take it faster, call me slave, or call me master. Don't want no complication. All the stars above, just give me some simulation. I need a slice of your bloody love. I got to hold your bloody love. I'm watching you, watch your dirty love. I got to hold your bloody love. Watch you too.
I'm a complete exhibitionist. I love to show off, but
it takes a lot of self-confidence, for sure. You have to be comfortable with who you are, your body.
That's what makes it good, too, if the girl's more free to, you know, express herself and, you know, be more forward, then it turns out a lot better.
I'm very comfortable doing it because since this is my business, this is what I do for a living, I've created this person, what I look like anyway, on the outside. I've created it in order to be able to work more. I mean, that's what, you know, we're all here for, is to work the most amount of days we can work in a year.
The whole thing to me is like a fantasy. Because before I started doing this, I was like in school and I was quite shy. In fact, if there was a camera in a room, I would not be anywhere to be found. So this has really helped me to come out and to be more creative and less shy.
And when I get on a video set and, you know, wear exotic outfits, I'm able to really express myself, what's maybe I wouldn't do in real life. I get to do it in a video.
Well, of course, looks attract you. I think that's what this whole thing's about, you know? They put girls in a video to attract you to the video. Helps out the song a little bit, or it just, it's something to watch.
Some keep to themselves, some are more open. But I was generally surprised because the people were so friendly. You know, you think they're going to be there, like this famous star, but they're very nice people.
Every video that you do, it's almost like, I think it's just like doing like a miniature movie.
And you wear it well. Madame O'Ness has gotten up no use.
Before I was modeling, I studied at university. I got a degree in psychology and communications, da-da-da. And then I hosted a television show, did a few features and stuff like that, and commercials and everything in front of a camera. Well, not everything.
The funniest thing that happened to me on a video was we were shooting the Traveling Wilburys video. And there were lots of different people and lots of actors were in it. And I arrived at the set that night to shoot, and I saw this guy on the stairs, and I was like, hi, how you doing? It's been a long time. Are you good? And I'm talking to this guy, and I start realizing he has no idea who I am. So the more I speak to him, I say, well, didn't we work together on something? He goes, yeah, it could have been. Which episode? And then I realize, oh, no, this is Woody Harrelson. He doesn't know me from Bob Soap. And I was like, if I could just vanish and just disappear. So I just, like, went, oh. And he says, no, I think you recognize me from the show Cheers. So I went, oh, great, he had to go and say that. So I disappeared and slinked away as fast as I could. Every video was so different. I danced around with Cheech. On a Tina Turner video I did for her Foreign Affair album, I shaved a guy's head in the tub and then poured water over his head with a saucepan. And on Alice Cooper, I was dressed up in an S&M outfit with a whip. So I whipped out and lashed out on that. And on Rod Stewart was a lot of fun because we got to sing the backing vocals and we all dressed up like 60s dolls and doing the 60s like dance, which is great fun. And in a video for a guy called Colin James, I pick up a seltzer bottle and it's like a scene at a dinner table and I'm annoyed at him and I pick up this bottle and I squirt him full on in the face. I suppose it was more fun for me than it was for him. But yeah, I wanted to do that a few times to some other people.
Oh, the Elton John was the Healing Hands, and it's a scene where we end up like a pond outside, and I get submerged under the water, and then the Healing Hands bring me up out of the water. I wear contact lenses, so I figured it would be safer if I took them out, because in case I lost it or get stuck in my eye, it would just be pain. So
took them out and I went under the water and I came up. And I had no idea where I was because I'm so blind. Without them, I can't see nobody. And the director was going, could you do it this way? But I don't even know which guy's the director. I'm like trying to figure out which guy's talking to me. So I said, you know, I'm having a problem seeing the camera. If you start over there and then you, you know, come in. And they came dollying in. They said, okay, we'll get the flag. And they put a flag up on the camera and was like, okay, now you just follow the flag, Mizera. And they were waving this flag on top of the camera as it dollied in. And I was like, thank you, you guys. But fun, you know, fun stuff. Haven't worked with a tiger yet. I'd like to work with a tiger. Recently, I went to Hawaii, and we had to go and rent the car, you know, to go and drive around in Hawaii. And these Hawaiian guys recognized me from the Amy Grant video. And they were all doing the hang loose sign when I come past. Hey, hang loose, you know. It's fun, you know, people recognize it. And they're very interested, and they come ask you questions about it. And they say, well, what's it like? What's the singer like? They want to know about the singer and, you know, shooting it. So it's great. It's good.
Trying to sneak in something that nobody wants. It's always that one little piece that we find that we love and the director is saying, no, 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 it's horrible. And we sneak it in somehow. And in the end, it ends up working usually and they like it. So it's just trying to push something to the other edge or take it a step further.
Oh, we've had to dress crazy animals like these lizards in the desert. We had to get some t-shirts made for them. And we'd never seen these lizards, so we didn't know where to put the armholes. And this one Komodo dragon, which is like a massive lizard, as big as an alligator, we had to put sunglasses on him, so we just put him on the end of a rake, put them on his face. That was really scary.
And one of the first ones was out in Mono Lake, of course, in the very freezing cold, and it involved midgets and greased men and a German actress. And so that's how I got my first start.
When a model starts crying because she has to wear a 6-inch heel or the dress is too tight and she's freezing, and I think that's a lot of fun to get people in things that they would never wear on their own.
Satisfaction guaranteed. Imagine every lover.
Left to Oregon when I was about 13, 14 years old to come back to Los Angeles. Started taking photos, meeting people, going to clubs. I was in and out of nightclubs when I was 15, 16 years old. The first one I ever did, I heard from a girlfriend of mine that they were looking for some dancers. So she told me to go down there, look as hot as I can look. And I lied, told them I was a great dancer and that I'd done this before. And they said, okay, well, let's see what you can do. Took me in this little room, put on the song, and said, let's see you move. And I danced and did my thing, and then that was it. The next day we shot the video. That was for Girls, 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 Motley Crue.
Girls, girls, girls.
The groups I've worked with, Young MC, Tone Loc, Colin James, Poison. I've worked with John Bon Jovi, Ivan Neville.
She could have been from anywhere. She could have had most anyone. I bet the girls need another one. Not just another.
Working with Bon Jovi, I didn't get to talk to him a whole lot. He's a really nice guy. He had a lot to do with the whole production of the video, so he was more on the other side of the camera most of the time. It was a good shoot. It was great. We did it out in Palmdale, out in the desert. There's only been one bed scene, but it wasn't really a love scene. This was with Bret Michaels in the Poison video, Every Rose Has a Thorn. You know, there was no love scene, but I guess it would be a fantasy. Fantasies are great. They've always treated me really great on the set. I've never had a problem. The guys in Motley Crue and in Poison, I had met previously through a photographer that I used to work for before I got into modeling. That's actually how I was in the Poison video. They phoned me, wanted to know if I wanted to be in it. And like I said, the Motley Crue video just kind of happened. But everybody's always really sweet to work with.
Hey Roy, it's quitting time, man. Let's go home.
That's school. Why don't you stay?
I'm out of here.
Okay, man. See, I'm gonna stay.
Thank you.
say agree. They always care, they're always there when you need satisfaction guaranteed. Imagine every lover, imagine every lover. You're mad all the time, my imaginary lover. You're mad any time. Yeah, yeah.
Say this, but sometimes it's a shame you paid for what I do. I love doing it. It's great. Rock videos are great.